everyone, it's Shannon here for Pink Fresh Studios. In today's video, we are going to do some foiling with some of the new stencils that just came out in Pink Fresh Studios' new Slimline release. Today, I'll be using the You Are Amazing stamp set as well as the coordinating stencils. This is a beautiful leafy set. I'm going to first stamp the image and then I will use these three stencils here to not only ink blend but also do some foiling as well. I'm going to start with a panel that's 3 3/8 by 8 3/8, so a little bit smaller than the front of a slimline card base. That's just so when I do adhere this panel down to the base, I will have a nice little border. I added some tape to the back side of the panel. I'm going to center it here inside my Misty, and then I will position this background stamp, this leafy background stamp from the You Are Amazing stamp set, over my panel, and then I'll pick it up with my Misty. The reason why I'm positioning it in kind of the middle of my Misty is that's to make sure that that background stamp completely covers the panel. If I were to push the panel to the edge and use just the edge of the Misty, I would get a little bare area on the side. So I went ahead and inked up the stamp with the black detail ink and then just went ahead and stamped that panel. Now that my panel stamped, I'm ready for my stencils. The You Are Amazing coordinating stencils comes with three. I'm going to use two for ink blending, and this one right here I'm actually going to save and use that for the foiling later. I'm going to start with these kind of wide leaves here, and I'm just going to position it over my panel and then use a couple pieces of painter's tape to hold the stencil in place, and then I'm going to do some very simple ink blending. I have a couple greens picked out. I'm starting with key lime here, just in coloring or just ink blending these broad leaves with this color. I found when I was ink blending that if I worked at the base of the leaf out towards the tip instead of ink blending in circles, my blending tool caught less on the stencil and it just was easier to blend that way. So I do recommend trying to kind of blend out from the base out towards the tip. Now these are a bunch of little leaves here that I'm ink blending with Meadow. This one I just found that it was easier just to kind of almost pounce the ink into or onto the paper and not move in circles. Just whenever you move in circles, the tool kind of catches on the stencil, which can be kind of frustrating. So now that I've finished ink blending, I went ahead and removed the stencil, and I've grabbed my third and final stencil. I'm going to line it up here with the stamped image, use my painter's tape to hold it in place, and then I'm going to move on to this Deco Foil Transfer Gel from ThermoWeb. I will use a palette knife here to pull some of this gel out. It's sort of paste-like. I'm going to load my palette knife up pretty heavily with the gel and then just spread it over the openings in the stencil using the edge of the palette knife to kind of make that gel flush as possible with the stencil. Now I do need to mention that I am using the older transfer gel. They have since created a new transfer gel, new formula. It is called Transfer Gel Duo. Now the good thing about this new transfer gel is that you can actually use it with heat or without heat. Today I'm using the old formula, so I am going to be using my laminator, but the new formula, the Transfer Gel Duo, you do not have to use a laminator to do this project, so that's really great. You actually would just, instead of using laminator, you would just run your project through your die cutting machine with your foil. So really awesome that you can still do this project even without a laminator or without heat. I am almost done here, just finishing up that little corner, and now that I'm done, I can remove my painter's tape and remove my stencil. I will go take the stencil over to my sink and clean this off pretty promptly because I don't want any of that gel to dry on it. I also need to make sure that this panel is completely dry before I move on to the foiling, and that panel there took about an hour and a half. So while my panel is drying, I'm going to move on to my sentiment. I have a sentiment stamp here from the You Are Amazing stamp set. I'm going to stamp it on to this black cardstock, but I am going to do some little heat embossing, so I did apply some anti-static powder first. Now I'm going to ink up my sentiment in Versamark ink, and once I've stamped it, I'll then dip it into some gold embossing powder and then just heat set with my heat tool. I'm now ready to trim this down a little bit. I have a ruler here, an X-Acto knife to trim it down. Just going to position that ruler right above the top of my sentiment and then just trim that off, so I now have a straight line at the top there. And then I'm going to grab my pencil and just kind of mark out where I'm going to stop, because I don't want to cut into that wonderful area. I'm going to leave like a little border around that. So I'll just position my ruler here again and then just use my X-Acto knife to cut just to those points that I marked with my pencil. Now that I've finished those two little sections, I'm ready to kind of move to my scissors. The first thing I'm gonna do with my scissors is just trim off the excess here on the sides. That top part is kind of like just a strip because the font at that top part of the sentiment is just very linear. And here at the bottom part where it says wonderful, it's a little bit more scripty, and that's where I'm gonna really kind of just fussy cut it. I am going to leave a little border around the word as well, just to keep it kind of consistent with the top, because the top has a little border as well. And once I finish kind of cutting around that wonderful, I'll just clean up the little areas here, right where the kind of the linear part meets the scripty part. And once I finish that, my little sentiment is done, and I'm ready for my second part of my sentiment, which is a word die. I use the friend word die here. This is from the Phrase Builder Hello die set. And I love that this friend die comes with not only the kind of the outline, but also the shadow layer. I use the outline and die cut it twice out of white cardstock and once out of mirrored gold. And now I'm just adhering the mirrored gold friend on top of one of the white cardstock layers. Now I've added some liquid glue to the back side of these stacked friend, and I'm just tapping off the excess onto a little scrap paper, and then I will adhere this stacked friend on top of that vellum shadow layer that I die cut. Then I will add a little dab of glue for my tittle for the eye. So I started first, I just glued the white, one of the white tittles down, and then I glued the mirrored gold tittle right on top of that, so that tittle is also stacked as well. Now for my last friend out of white cardstock, I added some liquid glue to the top of it, tapped off the excess once more onto that scrap paper, and now I'm going to adhere this to the back side of the vellum and the stacked sentiment. So this kind of sandwiches that vellum between the friends, and this will give a little lift to that vellum, so it's a little bit more opaque, and it'll make it a little bit easier to read that friend against the leaf background. So we are now ready to foil. My laminator has been on for 20 minutes, so it's hot and ready to go. This panel here is completely dry. That transfer gel is dry to the touch, but it also is clear. That's how you know when it's no longer opaque. You know that transfer gel is dry and ready to go. The foil that I'm using today is these transfer sheets here, the Emerald Watercolor, but there are a ton to choose from. Decofoil makes a ton of different looks, but I do really love the mottled look of this foil. I think it really adds to the leaves. But before I do any foiling, I am going to adhere this panel down onto my slimline card base. That's because earlier you may remember we did add some adhesive to the backside of that panel, and if I run that panel through with that exposed adhesive, it's going to make a mess. So I'm just going to adhere it now to my card base just to tidy that all up. Now I've already gone ahead and trimmed my transfer sheets here so that it will cover my front of my card base. You can use scraps, you can use bits, you don't have to have a sheet that completely covers, so definitely hold on to all your transfer sheets because they definitely will come in handy. And now I'm placing my card and my transfer sheets inside my carrier. This is just a piece of parchment paper. This is just going to ensure that my card kind of moves in and out of my laminator freely, but I do recommend using a smaller carrier than the one that I used here. This one was a little bit too big. If you used the transfer gel duo and you don't have to use a laminator to set the transfer sheet, you would just place your foil or your transfer sheet on top of your transfer gel panel and then run it through your die cutting machine, and that pressure will cause your foil to stick to the transfer gel. So either way, with the transfer gel duo, you can use a laminator or you can use your die cutting machine to transfer the foil. So once I ran it through, I then just removed the foil, and you can see I have this beautiful foiled background. These leaves turned out great. I love the color and just the shine. So now that my panel is foiled, I'm ready to basically finish this card up. I'm going to take my two sentiments here and attach them. I did add some foam adhesive to the backside of my black and gold emboss sentiment. That's just to give it a little bit of lift because I am going to have it go over the friend a little bit. I added some adhesive behind the friend and stuck that down, and now all I have left to do is just remove the backing on that foam adhesive and stick down my sub sentiment just below my friend word die, and that will actually complete the card. I'll now hold my card up to the camera so you can get a good look at all the details in this card. I love this beautiful stamped image. These leaves are gorgeous. Love that black and the ink blending. And the foil adds not only shine, but a little bit of texture and dimension. It just makes this card a little bit more elegant. I hope you guys enjoyed today's card and video. If you'd like any more information on the products I use, please check out the links below in the description. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful day.